casino in August. With Dwight Oakham. So put your hands together for Chase McKinney.
Saving the trees, my dog's got ticks, and chips got fleas. Why? picture, I got a mean Willie Nelson in. Have a simple song and start a revolution. I think the bad taxes and bills and not enough money in. Chris Farley, and was he funny? Why is the IRS still an institution?
Let's go. I was right there.
What the
fuck? Dude, I was getting thrown around.
I just muted him.
No, I was getting thrown around. I was trying to get the mic.
Yeah, he just got blasted.
Hang on, this is, I gotta tweak this just a sec.
Fucking assholes.
Hey, fuck. Dude, I used to Vogue, you know.
It was just going good, but I don't care. You mess with my guys, I will fucking go crazy.
Thank you.
So, I'm serious. I'm not to dwell on this intern thing, but she set herself up for this. Who works at a country station and doesn't know who Dwight Yoakam is? Kelly, you understand. You screwed this up, right? Dwight Yoakam? I know you're not getting paid, but you're totally fired. Okay. I don't even think the radio station has ever come across that before. How do we fire somebody that doesn't get paid? I don't know. You do it? Yeah. No, her. That one. Yeah, that one right there. Okay, we got it. We all got it. Genre, okay? This is for her. Blake Shelton. Luke Bryan? You do? Dirks Bailey? She's like, I so did not sign up for this. Joe, she doesn't need to come up. A public humiliation takes place wherever she's at. It's all good. Do you guys make them wear those outfits, by the way? Or did her mom set that out for her? Okay, now it's getting personal. So we went out with Blake for a week, and then we turned around and came right back and went out with Luke for a week. And so every once in a while, I like to steal their stuff and play it because, well, it's fun. So if you feel like dancing, it's okay. Because they're popular. Bennett, where were we last year when I pulled this out? I think it would be Denver. And they still let me play. But anyways, this next song, I don't know if you guys know any of the backstory. I'm originally from Lola, Montana. And it kind of cracks me up every time. So the other two people from Montana are here. All of us in the same state at the same time. That's pretty cool. Now, I always laugh whenever something like the CMT award or like this next song was up for Monday Night Football. And I crack up because I think, how can a kid from Lowell, Montana end up with a theme song for Monday Night Football? Well, the answer is he didn't. But he was this close until that Carrie Underwood girl knocked him out of the spot. And I hadn't heard of Carrie Underwood. Actually, that intern hadn't heard of Carrie Underwood. I'd heard of her once. But anyways, this was close. But no cigar. Which is the story of my life, you know. So, no, we didn't bring the plank. We brought the tractor. You're welcome. Go ahead. I'm just kidding. Now, being from Lola, Montana, pretty much everywhere I go is big city. But I'm curious if Olympia, Washington is too big city to have its fair share of rednecks in the audience. We got some rednecks? Apparently, yes. Do we got any hillbillies? I like it. Do we have any just plain old white trash like me? It's amazing how many of us own up to that now. I got four words for it. When rednecks get together. When rednecks get together. When rednecks get together. Thank you. Memphis, Missouri. We know it's not traditional to have a bass solo, but we're not really that traditional. On bass, Bennett Pullen, you can call him Tractor.
Since then, and
I never know who put me in this position. Because I go around and people who voted me into the number one spot on CMT are out there everywhere. And so every state we go to, every city we go to, I try to take the opportunity to say thank you for changing my life. When they say one song can change your world, this would be that song.
Stuff that happened this year.
Let's do something you guys, you guys want to sing along? Let's sing along here really quick. Said, oh, don't touch that. That's all explosives. I'm like, that's brilliant. Let's put a whole bunch of flammable fireworks right behind a stage filled with electricity on a super hot day.
You finally got to enjoy it.
Thinkers. They were right on top of it. But it was kind of cool. I mean, nobody got burned to death or anything like that. But as soon as we dropped the last note, it was like, boom. And I felt like I hit a home run. That was pretty cool. So I know we don't have 17,000 people here. We did some shows down at the Willamette Country Music Festival, and we were in the hangover slot, is what I call it. When you go on the first part of the day, so it was us and Little Big Town and Alan Jackson and Sonny Sweeney and Phil Vassar. I mean, it was just crazy, but we got the very first slot.
Then it was Carl.
And we were playing on Saturday. And so everybody tore it up Friday night. And we're out there at like 10 a.m. in the morning. And there's a quarter mile of people out there. I mean, you can see a whole bunch of lawn chairs and whatnot. And I was thinking, man, is anybody even awake? And so I said, I just want to see it once. I want to see 17,000 people do this with their hands. And I'm not kidding. There was like this wave of people that on their backs, they're laying in flat lawn chairs listening to the concert. They're like... And what's weird about it is when you're doing, like, we put a drum beat down and you could see the people up front were keeping time and so were the people in the back, but it was like this side was going this way and that side was going that way. And I was like, all right, stop. My vertigo is just driving me nuts because it was weird to do that. But anyways, I've totally cued this a couple times. Yeah. Can we, I just want to see it.
Yeah.
asked us to do a patriotic song right before the fireworks. So, hey, Josh, would you let me know, like, when the last song is, and we'll throw the... Thank you. I didn't even need to say it, did I? I just kind of went... Hey, okay. Hey, guys, how about a big round of applause for Josh, Dave, Jerry, Jeff, Cliff... Austin, there's a whole group of people that are out here all day. They get here before you get here. They set all this stuff up. They'll be here long after you go. They do a great job. It's a pleasure working with you guys. Thank you for having us out here. Once again, I don't know. What was I thinking when I started that? I remember what I was thinking.
I'm
ourselves, aren't we? Sorry. We're out with Ronnie Dunn a couple of years ago, and we released a brand new album that, once again, I need to say thank you, debuted at number 62 on iTunes Country Album Chart. For an unsigned, unplayed singer-songwriter in the nation, it was like me, Colt Ford, Tim McGraw, sitting at like 61, 62, 63. I was like, I'm good with that. But while we were out with Ronnie Dunn, we previewed some new songs off that CD. And I thought, well, since we're trying to get a new CD out here pretty quick, we'd preview some songs for you tonight. Let's do another one from the new CD. If we can just get your head bobbing, we're good. Sit through a couple of my songs, we should probably reward you with a little bit of
turn it loose.
I know most of you guys are going to be watching the fireworks and whatnot, but Mayo, Kelly at K Mayo. No, I'm kidding. He's going to have a meet and greet afterwards. I'm going to sign. Is the merch table over there? I don't see Mary. Is she? Oh, okay. Got it. All right. So we're going to do that while the fireworks are going off. So if you want to watch and sign, take pictures or whatever, we can do that then. We got a couple more songs for you. I mean, you've stuck it out this long. They're like, whose little girl is this, by the way? Where was she? I offered her a pick, and she looked at me for like 30 seconds like, I don't know you. And my parents said, don't take anything from a stranger. It's not candy. Just a pick. Yeah, I'm afraid of what's in there. No. I have... Is that like pure gasoline? Did you just put pure gas on the stage? Because I haven't smelled that since I dumped it in my gas tank in Montana. I'm pretty sure that's like Everclear.
There's going to be fireworks in a bit. That's a hazard.
Yeah, it is. You might want to take the clear explosive off the stage. That could be great. We should. You know what? That was my mistake. Dirty Rotten Pirate. You know what? I learned my lesson. We were touring through Colorado and Utah, and some dude comes out of the stands one night. I was out with Colt Ford. And I mean, big. We're talking like 300 pounds, but like railroad spike. Big. And he walks, I can see him. He's pushing his way up through like 8 rows of people, and he gets about 2 feet away from the stage, and he goes, Dirty Rotten Pirate, now! And at that point, what do you do? I mean, the guy had sausages on his hands. It's like, Dirty Rotten Pirate. I shook hands with him afterwards. It was like, I felt like a 3-year-old child shaking a finger. So anyways, we got some Dirty Rotten Pirates in the house tonight. We should probably accommodate that, because after what happened earlier tonight, I don't feel safe disappointing anybody. Is everybody feeling good about the show so far? Everybody getting what they want? I'm going to be able to drive out of here. No problems. Okay. Just checking. A little scared. Austin's a bad boy, but he ain't very big.
Thank you.
Sent it out to 6 million people, and then those 6 million, not all of them, but like a million of them played it. But on the first day, it took 60,000 plays on Spotify, which is super awesome. Spotify sent me $6.37. So I'm buying elephant ears for everyone after the show. And that everyone includes one of you, because I think they're about $6.37. We gotta get out of here pretty quick. So, anyways, thank you for having us out tonight. We appreciate it. Lakefair.
Take care of yourselves.